Hey, Rag family and friends. During this time of uncertainty, we want to share with you on a regular basis a thought or two that'll maybe encourage you or strengthen you or help you on your faith journey. And so this morning in my personal devotional time, I was reading Jesus' words in John chapter 14. And Jesus says this, "I'm leaving you with a gift, a peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is the gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid." You know, with all the turmoil in the world around us right now, we could really use this gift from Jesus, this gift of peace of heart and mind. And the way we receive that peace is by spending time in prayer, by spending time with Jesus. Now that many of us find ourselves with more time on our hands because we're having to stay home, and now that a lot of the activities that we used to do have been curtailed, we should be investing some of that time. I want to encourage you to invest some of that time in prayer. Now, I know you still have to do your jobs and you still have to make sure the kids are homeschooled and all that, but let's be honest with ourselves. We do have a little bit more time on our hands, and we could invest that in prayer and spending time with Jesus. And since we are spending more time with our families, why not bring them together as a family and pray together? Begin to pray with one another, share with one another our requests, and let's pray for them. Or we could pray for, I have some things written down here. Let's ask God to give our families peace and to trust in Him in this time of uncertainty. Or how about praying for those who are sick because of the virus? Or pray for protection for those who, if they catch the virus, could become very deathly ill. Or how about praying for those who are going through economic struggles because of the downturn in our economy? Or pray for our leaders, because they have a big responsibility trying to figure out what to do to protect our society. We should be doing all these things, and we could be praying about them. Hey, you say to me, "Pastor Jim, but you know, I don't have a family to pray with." Well, then pick up your phone. Call a friend. Call a fellow Christian. Ask them what they would like to pray about. And pray together and share together and encourage one another. Let's build one another up. Then watch how Jesus' gift of peace becomes a reality in your life, the life of your family, and the life of your friends. Let me give you a final word today from Paul's letter to the Romans in Romans chapter 15. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. God bless you. Have a great day.